Morning friends, so welcome back to our next topic. We are studying the chapter life process, and in this chapter we are starting the next topic, that is respiration. Respiration is also considered as an important life process. Likewise, we have the last topic we studied about nutrition. So here, first of all, we will know what is respiration. Many of you might be confused. If respiration means breathing or taking of oxygen and breathing out, that is not the actual respiration. Here, respiration means it is an oxidative process. It is a type of oxidation biochemical reaction in which the nutrients which we have taken or which we have ingested in our body, their breakdown takes place to release energy. So here we will define respiration. Respiration is a biological process in which oxidation of organic nutrients means the nutrients like carbohydrates, proteins, fats, and lipids. These are the major organic nutrients, and they are breakdown of us, means they are oxidized, and after their oxidation, release of biological energy takes place, and you know that biological energy is ATP. So, respiration is a biological process in which oxidation of organic food, especially carbohydrates, that is glucose, takes place. Or you can say carbohydrates or glucose, they are oxidized to synthesize or to release energy in form of ATP. Now see here, respiration is generally completed in two steps, and these two steps they are first one is breathing, and second one is cellular respiration. These are two phases of respiration, breathing and cellular respiration. Breathing is also known as ventilation. Now the first step of respiration is breathing or ventilation. Here what is done in this system, we inhale air. Means intake of oxygen and exhale of carbon dioxide. Means here resuffling and resuffling of oxygen and carbon dioxide gas takes place simultaneously. When we inhale air or when we take in air, oxygen is inhaled, and when we give out air, carbon dioxide is removed. So this first step, that is called breathing or ventilation, where we inhale air along with air, oxygen is inhaled, and when we give out air through our nose, then that exhaled air contains carbon dioxide. Now, as soon as inhaled air reaches in our lungs, lungs is our respiratory organ, you have studied in previous classes, especially class 8, class 7, class 8, and class 9. Lungs are the respiratory organ in case of human beings. So, during breathing, we inhale oxygen, and this oxygen reaches to the lungs. And from lungs, the oxygen reaches to the heart via blood. Blood carries the oxygen from lungs to the heart, and heart distributes it to the different tissues and organs of our body. Now, as soon as this oxygen reaches to our tissues and different organs of the body, then they diffuse in the organs or in the cells of the organs or cells of the tissues, and there the next step is that is called cellular respiration. So, here in this topic, in the respiration topic, we will study only breathing, the mechanism of breathing, and cellular. study that will be talking to you in other higher classes. So in this class you have to study breathing process or ventilation and different respiratory organs, breathing and gases exchange in human beings. So when oxygen reaches to the cell in the second system, cellular respiration is start, and there the actual oxidation of carbohydrate or glucose takes place along with oxidation of proteins and fats and glucose. But in this topic, we will basically focus on breathing or ventilation. In other language, respiration can also be defined as you know that we are using different types of fuel, like fossil fuels, coal, petroleum, LPG, diesel. So what is happening? We are burning of these fuels takes place, and then energy is released in form of heat. So respiration is also considered as a burning process, but it is different from burning process, and burning process that is known as combustion. Burning of any substance in which heat and light are produced. So respiration is also considered as a burning process, but here actual burning doesn't take place, because burning also requires oxygen and respiration is also requiring oxygen. Both are similar at some point but are different at other point. So today we will know that the difference between respiration and combustion. The first difference between respiration and combustion is, respiration means it is a biological process which occurs in living organism, whereas combustion is a physical process which occurs outside the living body. In respiration, oxygen is utilized and carbon dioxide is released. In combustion also, oxygen is required and carbon dioxide is released. That is similar, but difference is that the respiration is a biological process which occurs inside the living organism, and combustion is a physical process which occurs outside living body, in our surrounding, in our nature. The second difference is in respiration, oxidation of organic food or organic nutrient takes place, and energy is released in form of heat and ATP energy. In respiration, energy is released in form of heat, and that heat is produced in form of water vapors. And along with release of biological energy in form of ATP. But in combustion, heat and light are produced. Energy is released in form of heat and light. So that is two points of difference between respiration and combustion. Then we come to our next point, that is aerobic means types of respiration. So generally in living organism, two types of respiration are reported. The first one is aerobic respiration and second one is anaerobic respiration. Now what is aerobic respiration? Aerobic respiration means respiration which occurs in presence of oxygen. That respiration is called aerobic respiration, means presence of oxygen is must. Whereas in anaerobic respiration, presence of oxygen is not required, means this oxygen, means this respiration occurs in absence of oxygen or in presence of very limited amount of oxygen. Oxygen is present in traces, that is called anaerobic respiration. So basic difference between aerobic and anaerobic respiration is that the aerobic respiration takes place or occurs in presence of oxygen, whereas anaerobic respiration occurs in absence of oxygen. And anaerobic respiration is also known as fermentation. Fermentation, new word for you, not new. You might have heard this term in lower classes, in previous classes, especially in class 7 and 8. The fermentation process is the equivalent to anaerobic respiration. Anaerobic respiration is also known as fermentation. So that is the difference between aerobic and anaerobic respiration. This was an introductory part of the topic respiration. Other things I will discuss in my next class. Okay, thank you and good day.